Good morning, Seven Lakes. Please stand for the pledges. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible. As we begin another school day, let us take a moment to silently think about our day, our activities, and what we hope to accomplish.
Good morning, I'm Valerie and it's time for our Seven Lakes Sports Minute. Our tennis team recently wrapped up another successful season, advancing through playoffs to become area champions. Their season ended as they were defeated in the regional quarterfinals by defending state champion Memorial. They finished the season ranked 17th in the state. Congrats to another dominant season on the courts. Legacy Stadium is the place to be Friday at 6:30 p.m. as your varsity football team looks to continue their winning ways. We are on the verge of clinching a playoff spot, so come out and support our guys on the gridiron. Last year, our volleyball team got second place in the state of Texas. This year, our state runner-ups proved they were too much for the competition around Katy, as they clinched another district championship. Come out and support our girls as they are once again in the middle of another playoff run to the state tournament. Our cross-country team recently competed at regionals, the last step before going to state. Our boys team advanced to the state meet, finishing 3rd out of 24 competing teams. Our girls team finished 6th out of 24, and junior Molly Humes advanced to state with her 4th place individual finish. Congrats to all our cross-country runners on a great season and good luck to our state qualifiers. That's it for Sports Minute. See you next time.
Hello, good morning. My name is Claudia Boudreau and I'm Spanish for Spanish Speakers teacher. El Día de los Muertos, the Day of the Dead, is a Mexican tradition that combines Asian aspects of pre-Hispanic culture with Christian beliefs to create a unique event to honor our beloved ones that already departed. Day of the Dead is celebrated throughout Mexico, in particular the central and the south regions, and by people of Mexican heritage elsewhere. On November the 1st, we celebrate the infants, and November the 2nd is to honor and remember the adults, either our beloved ones or famous people that passed away to a better life. How we celebrate it? We create a traditional altar dedicated to our beloved ones. Day of the Dead altars, also known as ofrendas, offerings, are constructed to remember, honor, and please the dead. Altars are central symbol of the Día de los Muertos. Altars can include a variety of symbols and items that are reminders of the deceased or that were favorites to the honoree of the altar, but there are some elements that are considered fundamental requirements for an ofrenda. For example, photo, a picture of the deceased for which the altar is paying tribute is placed at the top and in the middle of the altar. Water, it's the representative of the purity of the soul. Bread, the most common food offering for the spirit, the most commonly used form of bread is called pan de muerto. Los cirios y las velas. Candles serve as a guide to light the deceased way in the ascension of the spirit. El cempasúchil is the bright yellow Mexican marigold, also known as the flor de muerto. Is the main floral adornment for altars. El copal, or incense. It is believed that as the aromatic smoke of the copal rises, it makes a connection with the dead. And also, el papel picado. These are the colorful tissue paper rectangles that are cut to display Dia de Muertos designs and hung from strings above others. I hope this information is helpful for you to get to know a little bit of this tradition. Thank you so much. Gracias.
I'm Catherine Wise, and I am the Korean Club President.
Hi, I'm Hannah Huang, and I'm the Korean Club Treasurer.
Korean Club, we have meetings discussing culture, food, and entertainment. Like last meeting, we had a meeting over Chuseok, which is like Korean Thanksgiving, where Korean families commemorate their ancestors.
And so tonight we had our Gwanggyetto Samulnori event, or KD Korean Culture Night, and it just what happened was a performance from traditional Korean percussion instruments, or a group that does that, they came and they performed. Also, there was a mixture of modern and traditional culture with b-boying. There's a lot of K-pop as well.
Since Seven Lakes is so diverse, you can't avoid seeing different cultures, and especially Korean culture. With the new wave of Korean media, it's good to know its traditional culture too. I think being educated in different cultures is very important because it gives you a different perspective on different morals and customs. Not every custom is like your own, and learning other ones can help enlighten you for future visits to other countries.
So I think it's important to learn other cultures because with Seven Lakes being especially diverse, the same thing. But with that happening, it's really important to be able to understand other people as well. It's a really nice way to get to know other people, to understand why certain people do other things. And for Korean culture, I'm Korean, so my culture is a culture that I love, and I just want other people to love it as well.
Hi, I'm Elena. I'm a senior at Seven Lakes, and this is my second year in Sensations.
Hi, my name is Venetia Vossen. I am a junior at Seven Lakes High School, and this is my second year in Sensations.
Hi, my name is Honor DeJay, and I am a senior, and I've been in Sensations for 3 years.
My name is James Stillwell, and I'm a senior, and this is my second year of Sensations.
So Sensations is a show choir here at Seven Lakes. We're made up of 15 people this year.
We sang a lot of musical, Broadway stuff, and during the second semester we sang choral music.
The theme this year is heroes and villains. Basically, it's a bunch of unique songs depicting various heroes and villains across Broadway.
Each song in the show is really representative of what it means to be a hero and a villain, and what it takes to be a hero and a villain.
I'm seeing Hellfire from The Hunchback of Notre Dame, seeing Be Prepared from The Lion King. I have a solo in Be the Hero, and I'm involved in a men's piece called I'll Make a Man Out of You from Mulan.
I'm the main lead in I'll Make a Man Out of You from Mulan. I sing a solo from Hercules called Go the Distance, and I sing a duet with James, which is called Hellfire.
I am a part of Apex Predator and I'd Rather Be Me from Mean Girls, and I'll be playing Janice, and I'm also part of all the group songs as well.
I'm a part of all of our group numbers as well as the female ensemble. I'm also in Apex Predator, I'm one of the plastics, and I am also a part of Evil Like Me. I'm Mal from Descendants.
Well, there's a lot of unique songs that depict like various heroes and villains.
And we've spent thousands of hours working on it, and all the sets and all the props look really great, and it's really just a good family experience for everyone to come out and watch.
I think people should come out and see this show because we've worked so hard on this. We've put so much time and effort into this. It's going to be insane. It's going to be amazing.
The show will be in the pack on November 2nd and 3rd, this Friday and Saturday. Our first show will be at 7 o'clock on Friday. The second one will be at 2 o'clock on Saturday and 7 o'clock again on Saturday night. The tickets are $8 for students and $12 for adults, $5 for Gold Card members, and $5 for teachers and staff.
Good morning from the Sparta capital. We are here to bring you electrifying news on the first ever Hunger Games at Seven Lakes.
Don't let the name fool you. This is not a fight to the death event, but instead a month-long marathon of competition. 14 tributes, two from each department, have most graciously volunteered for a chance to win Tribute of the Year. Right after this broadcast, the Tribute Parade will be introducing our fabulous contestants to the school.
We begin our first contest on Monday. This will be Penny Wars, where students vote for their favorite tributes with pennies. Pennies are positive points, but be careful. Silver and dollars are negative points. So if you want to effectively eliminate a teacher tribute, give them all the silver coins you can. This event will be held the week of November 5th through the 9th, and all the pennies will go to Pennies for Patients.
The following week of November 12th through 16th, we will have Food Wars. No, you will not be able to throw food at your most hated teacher, just the opposite. Donate cans to your favorite tributes to keep them in the game. At the end of the Food Wars, all cans will be donated to the Houston Food Bank and Kids Meals on Wheels, and we will be down to just four tributes left.
And after a short break for Thanksgiving, we will come back to the glorious Arena Games. Tickets to the event are a mere $1. Sponsor your favorite tribute and add your name to their banner. The tribute with the most sponsorships will enter the games with a point advantage, and proceeds will go to the Purple Pinky Project. The remaining tributes will fight along with their 10 arena kids in a series of physical challenges to be crowned the Hunger Games champion.
So make sure you don't miss a minute of the action.
Follow regular game updates on Twitter and Instagram at SLHS Press and tune in to Slamcast as we honor the fallen tributes. And now, head out to the main hallway and welcome our tributes.
May the odds be ever in your favor.